Hey everyone! Today I'm going to be walking you through how to create a custom leaderboard in Roblox Studio, and I will also be showing you how to make a basic coin item in order to increase that score. So, in order to start off, as always, open up a Roblox Studio world or a game you've already been working on. And then the first thing we're going to do in order to actually make the actual custom leaderboards is to go to our server script service, and we're going to add a script. And in this script, let's remove the default print statement. We're going to add just one variable, and that is going to be local players, and it's going to equal our player service. So game colon get service players. So, we have to first start by putting in players, because that's our player service, dot player added. So every time there's a player added, we want to do this. Then, we got to connect a function to that, so colon connect. And then inside the connect parentheses, we're going to put function with its own parentheses, and inside these parentheses, so we have a lot going on here. We have the connect parentheses, and we have the function with its own set of parentheses, and inside this parentheses, we have to give it the parameter of player. So every time a player is added, it's going to call this function, which we're about to write, and it's also going to give it the player, which is added. So the player is going to have all the information about the player. And now, we need to add a folder to the player, which is going to hold all the stats that we want to appear on the leaderboard. And that's why we have to do it on the player added event, because we have to add this folder and all the stats that we want to track to each player when they're added to the game. So, first, let's create the folder. In order to create a new something, and a new anything in Roblox, it's best to put it into a variable. So, we're going to call this leader stats equals instance.new folder. And then we have to change the name of this folder. So leaderstats.name equals leaderstats. It has to be leaderstats. And that is kind of what is pre-programmed into Roblox. This is built in. We just have to make the folder and give it the information to actually display it on the screen in the leaderboards in the corner. So it has to be named leaderstats. And then the last part is to add, is to change the parent of leader stats to the player. So there we go. Now we have a leader stats folder where we can add custom leaderboard stats to. So let's test this out and see what just adding the folder does. So we get into the game and nothing is really different compared to a base game. We have just me in the corner, but let's go to players and let's open me up really quick. If we look under here, now we have a folder called leader stats, which wasn't there before. So now the next step, so let me stop my program. The next step is to actually add some stats into this folder. And probably one of the best ones you want to add is an integer value. So a whole number that can be negative or positive. Just not, it doesn't have a decimal, it's just a whole number. So let's call this coins. So how many coins I've collected? Let's say I'm making a game where you can run around and collect coins. So this can be, or how many coins I've collected throughout the whole game, equals instance.new for quotation marks int value. So I've made the new value, and now I kind of have to go through a similar process like I did before. So let's do coins.name equals coins. And the name you're giving it here is actually going to be how it shows up in on the actual leaderboards in the right corner of the screen. So just make sure this is the name that you want displayed. The local, the variable name can be absolutely whatever you want. But the dot name equals, where you give it a string of the name, this has to be what you want to be displayed. Can be changed later too. Not a big deal. And now, let's set the initial value of it. So coins.value and I probably want it to equal 0. This can be, again, this can start at any value. If I wanted to start every player with 32 coins, I could. But I'm going to start it at 0 since that makes sense. And now I have to set the parent of coins. And what the parent of coins is going to be is that leader stats folder which you created. So equals leader stats. So then this is going to put our coins value inside the leader stats folder that we created. So now let me hit play and let's see what our game looks like now. So there we go. We have now created a custom leaderboards. It shows me, people, and it also has coins too on the right side. And one thing I do want to point out before I continue and show you more of what you can do with custom leaderboards is that this does work with teams. So let's say I add two teams really quick. I name this one red, change the color to red, and then I name this one blue, and I change the color to blue. And now let me turn auto assignable off for blue. I'm going to join the red team when I come in, and if it's an integer value or a float value, so a float value is a decimal value, for each team, it'll do a sum of all the players in that team. So, like, let's say you want to be the first team who gets the 50 coins. So then the team will now have a sum at the top of how many coins the whole team has. So that's a pretty nice built-in feature for us. But now, I also want to show you that you could also... You can make multiple different leaderboard stats that you want to track. So it doesn't have to be one, you can have multiple. It can even be different types. So let's say I want one called role equals instance.new. This one's going to be a string value, which is just text. Like these green on my screen, they're green. All of this green are strings. They're between the quotation marks, so they're strings. And so let's set the name to role dot name equals role. And I can do role dot value equals recruit. So everybody who joins the game, you immediately get the recruit role. Maybe you're doing like a war role play game or something along those lines. And now, just like how we did with the coins, we now have to set the parent of role to be the leader stats folder. So now, when I press play, I'm going to have two different leaderboard information listed on the screen. So I have my coins and I have a role. And as you can see, string values do not add to the total because strings aren't numbers. You can't add words together. So it just doesn't do it. Awesome. So now I'm going to walk you through the process of creating like a coin. I'm going to make a coin basically that will add a point to our coins leaderboard stat. So in order to make the coin, first let's create a part. And I'm actually going to use a sphere just to make it a little more like a coin. I'm also going to change the color to a yellowish. And now on this part, I'm going to add a script. And in this script, of course, we're going to remove that default print statement. I don't even know why Studio adds that. I really wish they just didn't. Just give me a blank script. And now, to start, we're going to need three variables. And the first variable is going to be just for the part that the script's attached to, so the coin. Let's call it coin. Local coin equals, I can spell coin, equals script.parent. And now we're going to need another variable. The second variable is going to be for our player service skins. Local players equals game dot game colon get service play. No, not A/B test service. Get service players. And now the final variable we're going to need is one I just like to call touch. And this is going to be a Boolean value, so true, false, true or false, and we're going to start it with false. So now, we have to connect a function to the touched event on our coin. So when a player touches this, we want to add 1 point to their coin leaderboard stat. So, first, let's get our coin. Dot touched. So that's our touched event. And now we want to connect a function to this. So connect, function, parentheses, enter. Now inside of this, let's first start with an if statement. This is where our touch variable comes in. This is to basically make sure that when we touch the coin, it doesn't just spam us with a bunch of coins, and it kind of does what it needs to before it adds another coin to our total. So it doesn't just spam us with a bunch of coins, otherwise it's gonna glitch out. And we'll have this equal false. So when touched equals false, then we want to set touch to true. Touch equals true. And then now we don't want it to do this code as long as it's in here. And first, let's grab the character. Oh, one thing I did forget, inside here, you have to put touched or any name for that. You have to put something in here. So this is going to be what touched the block or what touched the coin. And so our next steps is to grab the parent of what touched it. Because usually whenever a character touches it, it's usually going to be their arm or something that touches it. So then we're going to have to get the parent, which is the model that contains the humanoid part, all of its limbs, and probably the health script and everything else that a player has attached to it. So local character equals touched ed dot parent. And now we should check if this is actually, if what touched it is actually a human. Let's do local human equals character colon find first child which is a, it's a long thing, so it's just gonna look through the children until it finds the first one, so from the top to the bottom, which is a humanoid component is what we're giving it. So, and then we're gonna say if human. So if it finds a human, it's gonna have something in that variable, but if it doesn't find the humanoid component, that variable is going to equal nothing, basically. So if it has something, if it finds a humanoid component, then we want to local player, let's do local player equals, now we want to get the actual player object, which is in our players folder, not our workspace. The character would be in the workspace and our player is in here. So this is where the player services comes in. And we're going to use the player service to get player from character. So now we can give it our character and it'll return us the player that's associated with this character model. And now all we have to do is player dot leader stats. So just make sure you know the exact name of it, because the leader stats is inside the player. And then we have the coin's value inside of that dot value. So the path to get to our coins that actually change the value would be the player, since we got that from the get player from character. And then the next step is to get the leader stats, which we since is guaranteed to be in there since we add it to every player that joins the game. And then the coin's value, and then the value property on the coin's integer value. And now let's do plus equals one. So the plus equals, all it really does is it just adds one to whatever the current number is. So if that number is 20, when the player.leaderStats, when the plus equals happens, it'll be 21, 22, 23, yada, yada, yada. It just adds one to what it currently is. And now, let's just wait for a second so players can't spam it. And then we will set touch equal false. So now, go through this. When our player touches it, we're going to be given touch, and then we're going to check if touch is false. So if it's already running this code, this is not going to run. But if it's not running the code, then we're going to say, hey, we're running the code using the touch. Touch is basically just telling us we're running the code. And then we're going to get the character of what touched it, check to make sure that it's a human. If it's a human, then we're going to get the player associated to that character. And then all we're going to do is add one to the coin's value. Wait for a second and then say, hey, we're done with the code. We can do this again now. So now, let me hit play. And If I walk over to my coin, I touch it, it adds one to my score. Let me run over to it again. I just kicked it away. If I can chase it down, if I touch it again, add two. Easy as that. I can add to my score. And if I wanted to, I can even change it to something else. So also, let me anchor this. So if I wanted to, I can set the value of any other property. So let's say I wanted to change the role. So dot role dot value. And let's say I want this. You can't add to a string. So I'm going to set it to equal something new, like soldier instead of recruit. So now, if I head over here and touch this, my role is now soldier instead of recruit. And it's not going to change anymore because all it does is just set that once, basically. So if I want to just make like a pad where I can like select a role, I can just set the touch property and just change the role to that one. And now I'm that role forever now, unless I make another ball that changes it to something else. So it's as easy as that. That is how we make a custom leaderboard in Roblox. And please like and subscribe if you learned anything from this, if you thought this was helpful. And make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more. I haven't been posting a lot recently. I've been really busy in my own life. School is starting to also. So I'll try to post things when I can, when I get the motivation to do it. But I plan to keep on posting stuff. So make sure you subscribe for whenever I post a new video. All right, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.